Today, we're going to be taking a look at Assistant by the developers of Beaver Builder. Now, this isn't a Beaver Builder plugin. It's a generic plugin to work with WordPress. And what it really does is it's there to streamline your workflow and make life a little easier. Now, this is an early release. This is basically, you could say, a public beta release. It's not version one, so it's still quite limited in what you can do. But I do think it shows a certain level of promise. And if I open up the API, which they're talking about with the final release, so third-party developers can kind of plug into it and then use their tools alongside it, I think it could be quite a useful little tool, especially if you want to speed up your WordPress workflow. So if you're interested in seeing what this is all about, then join me and I'm going to take you through a first look into Assistant. So this is Assistant by Beaver Builder, but like I said at the opening of the video, you don't need to rely upon Beaver Builder or even have Beaver Builder installed. This is basically an agnostic plugin for WordPress. So once you've got it downloaded and installed, you're just going to see a new entry on the top bar while you're in the dashboard called Assistant. If we click, we'll enable this little docked area. Now, by default, it's on the right-hand side, but you can dock it on the left-hand side if you prefer. So there's options there should you want to do that. Now, once your Assistant is enabled, you're not restricted to just looking at this inside the dashboard. You can go back over to your site, and once you're back over your site, that will stay docked wherever you've positioned it. So what exactly does it do? Well, at the moment, we have to bear in mind that this is a pre-release. This is pre-version one. It is available. It's a publicly released plugin, so you can test this out yourself, but it's going to have kind of some restrictions on the, you know, the kind of feature set that it has because it's still in open development. Now, one thing that is going to be cool about this, they are going to have an open API, so third-party companies can integrate their plugins directly into this Assistant. So if Elementor wanted to integrate into it, they could do just that once this is available and the API is open. But let's just take a quick overview of what is available right now and see, like I say, if this is something you think would be useful for you. It's fundamentally a productivity enhancement tool. So if we take a look, we've got a series of different icons. We can click to open up home, and this will give us some information about the actual site that we're looking at. So we've got things like the current page that we're on. So you can see I'm on the home page. If I wanted to, I can edit the page, and we'll take a look at that a little later. We can see the recent posts, and this includes posts, pages, you know, advanced custom fields, custom post types, those kinds of things. So vehicles, for example, are custom post types, dealerships, custom post types. If we click on vehicles, we can see then all the vehicles that are included in that custom post type. And then we've got a context menu option that allows us to do a range of different things. We can view the page or post. We can click and that will open it up, keeping this available on the right-hand side. So we come back in, you can see it does jump back out. So it is a little inconvenient. It would be nice if this stayed in place and open so we could just open a new page up and the refresh would be separate to the actual Assistant. But, you know, it is still pretty early days. If we want to edit a particular post or page or something, we can do just that. So let's just say we'll take this test post. We'll click on that. And now I want to, I can preview it, or I can edit this inside the admin, or I can edit some of the basic options directly inside here. So we take a look, we've got things like the URL we can click to, the title for the post. If we click to show more details, we've got some basic information like you'd expect to see in the right-hand column of your normal post editor in part, you know, in the dashboard of WordPress. So things like the visibility, the status, the publish date, any taxonomies. You can create new taxonomies directly from here. You can insert tags from here, excerpts, attributes. You can even change the actual template that's being used if you're using something like Elementor, where you've got a range of different sort of templates like your canvas and your full width. You can even change the featured image. So it's still pretty basic, but if you want to do just some quick edits, I think this is a super useful little way of using things. We can enable or disable comments. We can manage comments from inside here. There's a ton of useful things that we can do. So that's the one option. And if we make changes, we can easily do that. So they say we'll change this from test post to edit, and we'll just say this is an Assistant post. Okay, so once we've done that, you see now we get an option at the bottom that says to discard the changes, or we can hit publish. So we'll publish that, and now we've changed the name of that particular, or the title of that particular post. We can come back out of this, go back to our home section. We can search if we want to. We can also go to the admin. We can toggle the UI brightness. So if we want, we can switch it into dark mode. And we've also got the option then to create a new post from here. So we click on create a new post. You can see we can choose, is it a post, page, template? You know, if you're using ACF, custom post types and so on, everything is listed inside here. Now, it would be nice to see in the future, hopefully this is something it'll bring, where we can manage exactly what's going to be shown inside here. That'd be pretty cool. So, you know,
a starting point, useful, with scope to increase its usability and, you know, what we can do with it kind of thing. We can create a draft from here. We can do all those kinds of cool things. One thing I do like about this, though, is if we go to posts, for example, we can tag these. So we can mark them as favorites. So we can say we like this one. We want to mark that as a favorite so I can easily come back and see my favorites. And I can filter based upon these options at the top. We can also apply labels. So there's lots of really useful things we can do directly inside this particular section. Now, while we can easily add things to favorites, I would like to see the ability to tag these directly inside here. So we've got favorites. I'd like to add that label straight in. You can see if we cut to the filter, we can choose filters, but we can't actually apply any kind of label to these. So let's just click to edit. We'll come down and we can see we can add a label from here. So we'll say we'll set this to be a green label. And once we've done that, we can come back out of this and then we can come back up. We can say we want to filter these based upon the label. So you can see that allows us to filter it. So it is nice. It is pretty quick as well to work with. You can see that I'm just running around. There's no pausing, I think, going on in this video. This is exactly as I'm experiencing it. So it is pretty quick. I'm on a SiteGround hosting, so there's nothing special. It's the lowest sort of plan on SiteGround. But you can see it is a pretty quick way of working. So this is all pretty cool. And you can see we can come up to the top and we can choose any of these different sort of sections. We can come up and display these as lists or thumbnails. It's up to us how we want to do it. We can disable any of these. We can see exactly what we're dealing with. So that first part is pretty cool, the content. Thing I do like though is the media library. We can, if we want to, immediately upload any kind of file directly into our media library, all done inside this particular section. Like before, we've got a series of options. We can view the attachment. We can grab the link to that, which is quite useful if you want to quickly paste this in somewhere else. Easier than jumping back into the media library for a start. We can edit in admin or we can delete it from here. We've also got the same kind of filter options at the top. We can't add these to our favorites though, which is a little bit of a shame because that could also be quite useful, where we could then just filter based upon our favorites as well as things like, you know, where we can apply the label. That's all we can currently apply to it. So that's pretty cool, and it's all drag and drop. So if you want to upload something, I'll just grab a thumbnail. I can just drag that over, drop it on there, let that go through and say, there we go, that's uploaded. And we now have that uploaded. So we can click on it and we can do all the normal things like adjusting the metadata, alt text, description, info, the file URL, the link. We can add labels from here. So we can say we want this to be a red label. That's pretty cool. We can view the attachment, delete it, or edit inside our admin. So media management could actually be quite quick using this kind of option where we can group things, where we can set labels and all those kinds of pretty cool things. Next up, we have the option for comments. So currently I don't have any real comments other than the sample comments here, but you can see we can filter these based upon the normal criteria you'd expect inside the dashboard, pending, approved, and so on. We can click on it and we can view that information, such as the email address it came from, the IP address, when it was submitted. We can go and reject it. We can reply to it. We can spam it. We can edit it or we can delete it. Pretty cool. We can take a look at any updates we may have and manage those updates directly from here as well. So currently you see there's no updates, but if there was anything, we could let them list it inside here and then action that directly inside the assistant. Finally, we've got the option to manage the apps so we can adjust these to get them exactly how we want. We can switch it to dark mode if we want to from here. We can adjust the positioning of this. So we can say top left, you know, whatever is the best option for you. You can even have this floating so you can just move it around wherever you want and then kind of dock it, you know, when you're kind of ready to have it as part of your design. But overall, I think it's quite a useful starting point. It has a lot of potential. The fact it's currently free and hopefully it will stay free. When they get that API out there, I think when that's rolled out and, you know, third-party companies come on board and maybe embrace using this, then I think that could be a really exciting prospect. Until that happens, it's useful. I would put it into my category of nice to have but not essential, you know, but it's quite useful. So that's the assistant over at Beaver Builder. Let me know your thoughts.
So there we go. That's assistant from the developers of Beaver Builder. What do you think? Something that you think has legs or you just think it's a bit of a waste of time? Let me know in the comment section below. As always, if you want to get more out of WordPress, take a look at the videos you can see on screen right now. They're going to help you get a ton more and really up your game with WordPress. As always, all the applicable links are in the description below. My name's been Paul C. This has been WPTuts, and until next time, take care.